Welcome back, students. We were discussing the topic respiration in organisms and the subtopic in which breathing underwater. So in last session we have seen how breathing takes place, or you can say respiration is brought about in the fishes. Let's see it in other animals. So gills are also present in the other aquatic animals also. They have outfoldings of the body surface suspended in water. As you can see here, they are mainly out surface present. The crustaceans, you can say, which are found in the aquatic animals, sea stars, which are also called as starfish, again segmented worms or polychaetes, mollusk and crustaceans, fishes, young amphibians. So total surface area is greater than the rest of the body, which are basically useful for the absorption of oxygen. Next comes example of earthworm. The respiratory surface of the earthworm is its skin. So the gases exchange is basically taking place through the skin. The oxygen diffuses through the skin into the capillaries, okay, and the blood in the capillaries picks up the oxygen which contains the hemoglobin and transfer it to the body cells. Again, the damp soil helps to keep the earthworm's skin moist. If it's too dry, the skin dries out and the earthworm suffocates. And if it's too wet, then that means it can be observed during the rainy season, the skin cannot obtain adequate oxygen from the water. So basically the earthworm's skin has to be moist for the proper, you can say, body temperature or maintenance of the oxygen level in its body. Now the upper, the epidermal layer has the blood capillaries which have looped out from the vascular system and circulating the blood, and these blood capillaries are so close to the skin that the gases can diffuse from the surroundings into and out of the blood through the skin and the capillary walls, and the blood contains hemoglobin in the solution which circulates the gases through the body. As you can see here, this is suppose the earthworm's skin. These are the dorsal blood vessels, this is the ventral blood vessel. Okay, so here CO2 is given out and O2 is taken inside these capillaries and it diffuses from the surrounding into the blood vessels through the skin of the capillary walls, and the blood contains the hemoglobin in which it circulates throughout the body. So students, in this session we have seen about the gills in the aquatic animals. Like, there are various aquatic animals present, like sea stars, segmented worms, mollusks, fishes, crustaceans, amphibians. They all have gills which are basically responsible for the breathing process of the animals. Again, we have seen the example of earthworm, for which the main respiratory organ for its breathing is basically skin, and oxygen diffuses into the skin where the capillaries are present, and from capillaries it goes to the blood, and this blood carries oxygen to all body parts, and this is how the exchange in the earthworm's skin, exchange of gases in the earth's body takes place.